अस्सलाम वालेकुम टू वन एंड ऑल, दिस इज़ प्रोफेसर पठान मोहसिन खान महमूद खान फ्रॉम JET आर्ट्स साइंस एंड कॉमर्स कॉलेज फॉर वुमेन मालेगांव। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस विथ यू IUPAC नॉमेनक्लेचर इन ऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स फॉर BSc एंड MSc स्टूडेंट्स। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। सिस्टमैटिक IUPAC नेम फॉर्मेट कंसिस्ट ऑफ 5 पार्ट्स। फर्स्ट पार्ट इज प्रीफिक्स और प्रीफिक्सेस विच इज़ ऑप्शनल। Second part is infix, which is also optional. Third part is root word. Fourth part is primary suffix. And this root word and primary suffix both are compulsory. And the last part, which is a fifth part, it is a secondary suffix, which is optional. Now, let's take a look on the meaning of each and every part in the systematic IUPAC name format. So first part, that is prefix or prefixes, which is optional. It includes side chain, substituents or functional group with lower priority. Second part, which is infix, it is also optional and it includes the word like cyclo, spiro, etc. Then root word, which is a compulsory part. It indicates the number of carbon atoms present in the molecule. Primary suffix, which is also a compulsory part. It includes saturation or unsaturation in the molecule. The last part, which is the fifth part, it is also optional and it is a secondary suffix and it indicates the functional group with highest priority. Now, going into detail, we will first consider the compulsory parts, that means root word and primary suffix. So take a look on the root word. Root word or word root is nothing but the number of carbon atoms or chain in the molecule and is often called as parent chain. So here in front of you there is a table in which there are two columns. The first column includes the chain length and in second column there is a root word for that particular chain length. If the molecule contains only one carbon, then the root word is meth. If it has a 2 carbon, then the root word is eth. If it has 3 carbon, then it is pro. If it has 4 carbon, then the root word is bute. If it has 5 carbon, then the root word is pent. If there are 6 carbon, then the root word is hex. If there are 7 carbon, then the root word is hept, and so on. Now, after considering this table, one of the questions may arise is that what is mean by parent chain? So here, parent chain is the longest continuous chain in the molecule which contain functional groups such as double bond, triple bond and substituents or side chains. Now, next compulsory part is primary suffix. So as I told you, primary suffix indicates the saturation and unsaturations in the molecule. So if there is a saturated carbon chain, then the primary suffix has the name ane with alphabet ane. So family name becomes alk plus ane, that means alkane. Now for example, if there are 4 carbons, that is CH3, CH2, CH2, CH3. So the root word becomes bute for 4 carbon. And the primary suffix is ane, that means ane. So the IUPAC name of that particular compound becomes butane. Similarly, if there is an unsaturated carbon chain with one carbon-carbon double bond, then primary suffix has the name ene, that means ene. So family name becomes alk plus ene, that means alkene. For example, CH3, CH double bond, CH, CH3. So here there are 4 carbons, that's why root word is bute. And as you can see that the position of the double bond is at the second, that means the double bond start from the second carbon. You can give the number from any side, from left hand side or from right hand side. The position of the double bond remains 2. So that's why its family name or IUPAC name becomes bute plus 2-ene, that means bute 2-ene, or we can simply say that 2-butene. Another example is also given here, CH2 double bond, CH2, CH3. Now here, double bond start at the first carbon. Here you cannot give the number from the right hand side, because if you do that, then the position of the double bond will comes at the third position, and we have to give the number from that side, from where the double bond gives the lowest number. That's why we have to give the number to that particular molecule from the left hand side, and in this way the double bond starts at the first carbon. Now here four carbons are there, that's why it is bute, that means root word is bute. And as the double bond start at the first position, so it is a 1-ene, so IUPAC name becomes bute 1-ene or 1-butene. Now the third case is when the unsaturated carbon chain contains one carbon-carbon triple bond, then its primary suffix has the name ine, denoted by Y-N-E, and here the family name becomes alk plus ine, that means alkyne. For example, in this example which are given here, there are four carbons continuously, and we have to again give the numberings from that side, from where the carbon-carbon triple bond gives the lowest number. So we have to again give the number to that particular molecule from the left hand side. And here carbon gets first priority, the carbon which has a triple bond. Okay. And here as there are four carbons, hence the root word is bute, and the position of triple bond is 1. So 1-ine, that means bute 1-ine or 1-butine. Now similarly, take another example. Here CH3C triple bond C, CH3. So again there are four carbon, so root word is bute, and here the position of the triple bond comes at the second. You can give number from any side, the triple bond gives the second positions. You can give from right hand side or from left hand side, you can give the number from any side, and it will get the second positions. That's why the IUPAC name becomes bute 2-ine or 2-butine. Okay. Now we will consider in detail saturated and unsaturated carbon chains. So first of all, we will consider the grammar in writing the IUPAC name. So these are the three grammars which you have to remember. The IUPAC name must be written as one word. However, there are some exceptions, and we will consider these exceptions in another video. And the second point is the numbers are separated by commas. Any numbers, the numbers which indicate the position of double bond or triple bond or substituents, they are separated by commas. And the third grammar is the numbers and letters are separated by hyphens. We will use these grammars in the IUPAC nomenclatures of the compounds. So first we will consider the IUPAC rules for alkane nomenclature. Now here you can see that the first rule for alkane nomenclature is find and give the numbers to the longest continuous carbon chain. Okay. Now you have to find out the longest continuous carbon chain, and here is in zigzag manner, and you have to give the numbers. Okay. You can give the numbers from any side if it is a normal hydrocarbon. normal hydrocarbon, that means it doesn't has any substituents. So if it has no substituents, then it is a normal hydrocarbon, and its name is preceded by N, small n. Here N means normal. Okay, so here in the first example, this molecule has a longest chain or longest continuous carbon chain, which contains 5 carbon, and they are numbered as shown. And as these hydrocarbon does not have any substituents or any branching, so that's why it is a normal hydrocarbon, and that's why its IUPAC name is given by preceding it with the small n. So its name becomes n-pentane. Similarly, in another examples, there are 6 carbons in a continuous longest chain, and here also there is no branching, no other substituents, so it is also a normal hydrocarbon, and its name is n-hexane. Now consider the second rule. What you have to do? Identify and name groups attached to this chain. Number the chain consecutively, starting at the end nearest substituent group. Designate the location of each substituent group by an appropriate number and name. So here, look at here in this particular examples. There is a longest continuous chain, and this chain of continuous carbon is selected by pink circle. You can see that. And here there are two possibilities of giving the numbers. We can give the numbers from right to left hand side or from left to right hand side. When we give the numbers from right to left hand side, then in this longest continuous chain there is a one substituent, that is CH3, and it will occupy third positions if we give the number from right to left hand side. And in the same molecule, if we give the number from left hand side to right hand side, then the same methyl group take the position, which is 4. So here what you have to do, you have to remember that you have to give the numbers from that side from which the substituent gets the lowest number. So that's why out of these two possibilities, first one is correct, because in the first case the methyl group will be at third position, but in the second case it is at fourth position. So correct name is 3-methylhexane, not 4-methylhexane. Here it is a saturated hydrocarbon. Okay, so first of all, what you have to do, you have to select the longest continuous chain, and it has a 6 carbon, so root word is hex, and it is a saturated hydrocarbon, hence primary suffix is N, that means hexane. Now what you have to do, you have to give the position of the substituents, and these substituents with its position, it is preceded by the family name, that means hexane. So it is a 3-methylhexane. Now third rule, if there are two or more same type of simple substituents, then they should be prefixed by di, tri, tetra, penta, etc. For example, the number of methyl groups are indicated by di and tri in the following cases. Here first of all, we have to select the longest continuous chain. So here longest continuous chain contains 3 carbons, and they are under the pink loop, and here at the second positions there are 2 methyl group, one is above, another is below. So here what you have to do, both are the same type of substituents, both are methyl groups, okay, and both are attached to the same carbon, that means the position of both the methyl group is same, 2 and 2. So here first of all, we have to write down the positions of the two methyl groups, and their position is separated by commas, so 2, 2. Then after the number we have to give the name, and the number and names, they are separated by hyphens, so we have to give hyphens. Then dimethyl, because there are two CH3, so it is a 2-2 dimethyl. Here longest continuous chain has 3 carbons, so its root word is prop, and it is a saturated hydrocarbon, hence primary suffix is ane, so IUPAC name is 2-2 dimethyl propane. Okay, now comes to the point number 4 or rule number 4. When the series of locants containing the same type, when the series of locants containing the same number of terms are compared term by term, that series which contains the lowest number on the occasion of the first difference is preferred. So look at here, in this molecule, first of all, what we have to do, we have to select longest continuous chain. And as you can see that the longest continuous chain has 10 carbons and there are 3 methyl groups at different positions. So what we have to do, we have to give the name. In that manner, you can see that here